still completely pitch black outside. It's basically the middle of the night and I didn't sleep too much. I want to say like 3 or 4 hours. It's not because I was like too excited for today. I guess I had a lot of anticipation, but wow, we're up early in order to take a fun day trip out of Seoul. Need to get out of Seoul early and get there. I wanted to get there as soon as I could. It's currently minus 10 outside. It is a little warmer than it has been. These past few days have been brutal and it will get warmer as the day goes on, which is good. But I got quite a few layers on and because we're heading to the mountains, it's gonna be cold. So I have all my accessories here too. I feel like this should be enough, hopefully. Honestly, thank goodness for being able to heat up your car before you get in it. It feels so cozy and nice in here. I got some tea. I'm hoping this is, it's barley tea. Does it have caffeine? I don't know, but I feel like I need caffeine. I just got some little bread to have on the way. I will be hungry for breakfast soon. But anyway, good morning. Thank you for being here for such an early start. I'm very excited for today. We're taking a day trip out of Seoul. We're going to Pyeongchang, an area I've never been to, but I've been wanting to go while it's the winter time because the mountains there are full of snow. It looks so pretty. So I hope we can have fun looking around, but to get there, it is a 2.5 hour drive. So let's get going before the rest of Seoul wakes up. 하루 시작 한 잔의 카페 그리운 맘 마치 너 같아 Oh you are You are baby 따뜻한 The further we've gone along, the more and more snowy it's looking. The mountains are definitely more covered over here. It looks really pretty. The car is also telling me that it's minus 18, which is a lot lower than I was originally expecting. 300m 앞에 그 커브 구간입니다. I stopped by the final Hoenggye, which is like a rest stop, but the one before our destination. These places are always massive, and for some reason the toilets are always very advanced, which is nice when you're stopping by on the side of the road. But the screens show like which cubicles are occupied, and then as you walk down you have the corresponding lights to see which cubicle is free. It's very cool, and I've never seen that before coming here. They also have so much food, and of course I'm charging the car, which I eventually managed to get done. It said I was going to be at 20% when we arrived at the mountain, and I don't want something to happen where I get stuck in a mountain without being able to charge the car. So I was like, let's do it now. The fast charge is occupied, so this one will take about 20-30 minutes. So it's fine. It's nice to have a little rest and break up the trip a bit from driving. Stop, it is so cold. I need to get all my layers on. Everyone is wearing like proper hiking boots, which I definitely don't have. I'm gonna switch to trainers though, because I feel like that's better than UGG boots. This is already unbelievable. The car park here was actually the only part of the road that was snowy. The rest was all cleared out, and I think that's because it snowed, I think, 2-3 days ago. If you're coming here the day after it snows, it takes a while for them to clear the road, so do be wary of that if you're driving. But yeah, if it's been a few days, it's fine, and it really was. There was not any snow on the road, so they cleared it well. Getting here public transport wise, you would definitely need a taxi to get up the mountain here, but getting to Pyeongchang in general, I will leave directions in the description box if you're wanting to get here public transport. But yes, we've arrived, so let's get a ticket and then we'll head in. Thank you. This is where the sheep are. Oh, they're so cute. I kind of want to feed them. Hey, 감사합니다. Would you like some? The trees are crazy. I feel like that's one of the biggest things when I come out for day trips like this that are weather dependent. Like getting the timing right is not easy at all, but I feel like coming here, you want to come like a few days after it snows or the day after it snows. Actually, when it's snowing, you won't be able to see anything, but like the next day or a few days after, it's so pretty. Yours belly rubs. You can really see how deep the snow is here. Like this just shows you. I think they said they got 40 centimeters worth of snowfall early this week. So yeah, that's a lot of snow. Oh gosh. It's so deep. That's the end. It's a lot smaller than I thought it actually was. There's another like wind turbine that's on the hill, like just single one. It looks so pretty that I've seen in like reels. So I think I'm gonna go and try and find that. But like that's not in the paid section for like what you get a ticket for. That's everything. So quite small actually. Okay, I'm gonna try going up this road. See where this takes us to. Oh, this is the trail I was looking for. Sonjalyong. However, this is what I was looking for, but it's all the way at the top. Okay, so I think we're gonna pass on seeing that, but I am gonna walk up for like maybe half hour. Yeah, I'll do like a half hour little hike, see what we can see. Morning. Oh, that's so much better. Oh, just walk past this full group of hikers and I feel so out of place. They're like fully decked out in, you know, the full-on hiking gear. They got the hats, the masks, the sticks, the shoes with all the spikes in, and I look with my little hat and scarf and my freaking Kate Spade bag. I just look like I'm a lost tourist. Just zooming my way past everyone. And actually, in fact, I think this maybe better than just going to the ranch. Like if you're coming all the way to go to the sheep ranch, you might as well come up here. What I've walked so far, like this isn't a hard trail. Obviously I'm not doing the full thing, but just this amount, as I say, out of breath. But walking wise, it's actually fine. And my New Balance trainers are holding up well.
I don't know.
is a course going down here. And this one is 0.1 kilometers. Let's go to that. Shikuro. Just as I was turning around at the mountain, one of the ajushis told me that it was only another 40 minutes until reaching the top, and I was like, so close, but like still so far. And also, I was starving, and at that point, it started to go into like the woods. Now I decided to come down, and now I'm gonna get some really nice food. It just feels so much better when you've been walking. How many steps have we done? 10,000. Easy. Got the mandu rice cake soup. So it's got all these rice cakes in, and look at the size of the mandu. Oh, it looks so good. Let me try. I'm sure you can see like all the smoke coming off air. It's so nice to have something warm. This soup is a bit spicy though. Typical Korean. There's only a couple of restaurants and a cafe here, and the rest is all like street food. So I'm thinking of getting some warm street food for dessert, because that's always a good idea. Oh, this one is shut. I've seen pictures of this one and it's so cute. It's like the bungabung fish bread, but they do it in a sheep shape instead, which is so cute and themed. I'm gonna have to find something else. I ended up getting hotdog instead. This is my favorite Korean snack, like street food wise. It's cooked in oil and inside there's like seeds and honey. It's so good. And I'm just enjoying it with this pretty view. I got hotdog sauce all over me. I've been craving going out and kind of exploring, going out on an adventure. So I feel like this has kind of got me started. And it's nice to enjoy winter in like the most out there winter environment, even though it was freezing, but a lot of fun. I'm now gonna head back, do the drive all the way back to Seoul. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.